Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how we can easily create database and then table and how we can easily write simple queries to fetch data from your table. So I'm going to show you all of that in Microsoft SQL Server 2022. So in my previous videos, I have already shown you how you can easily install Microsoft SQL Server 2022. And then I have also shown you how you can easily install SQL Server Management Studio as well. So I'm going to launch that SQL Server Management Studio. So I'll just simply go to search and I'll just simply search over here SSMS. And this will show you SQL Server Management Studio version 19. So I'm going to just simply open our SQL Server. So our SQL Server Management Studio is currently launching. And you can see our SQL Server Management Studio is ready to launch. So this is our server names and I'm going to use Windows authentication only. So just I'm going to click on connect. And there you go. You can see it is rightly connected with our SQL Express. So I'm going to expand the database. So in my previous video, when I was demonstrating, you know, installation of SQL Server, I have created this database called employee. Now I'm going to create one more database. So I'm going to right click on it and going to click on new database. And here I'm going to give a database name as demo DB. And I'm just going to click on OK. And you can see that our demo DB is rightly created over here. So let's, you know, open a new query window. So I'll just simply click on new query and it's going to open a new query window. And here I'm going to use our database demo DB and I'm going to execute this. And you can see command completed successfully. So I am currently using our demo DB. And now if I write a simple create table statement to create a table, so create table players, and I'm going to give a couple of column, so player ID int, and I'm going to give another column as player name, let's say with varchar 50, and I'm going to just simply execute this statement. Okay, 50 numlock was not open. Yeah, sorry. Yeah, so I'm just going to execute this statement. And there you go. You can see command executed successfully. So now I'm going to insert a couple of values in the table. So insert into players. And I need to mention the couple of column name, which is player ID, comma, player name. Just end the bracket and then values, and inside parentheses I need to mention the player ID. I'll give 1 and then I'm going to write Virat Kohli, and I'll end a quote and then I'll give a semicolon, and I'll just simply execute this insert statement, and you can see one row affected. So similarly, I'll insert one more data in the table. So this time I'll give ID as 2 and I'll change the name to Rohit Sharma, and I'll just simply execute this statement once again, one row affected. So if I now simply do select star from players, just simply execute this select star command, and you can see the output player ID Virat Kohli and player 2 Virat Rohit Sharma is rightly shown from our table players. So in this way, you can easily create a database and you can easily, you know, create a table on that database, and you can insert a couple of values and you can easily fetch that from our table. So that's basically all about this video. In my next video, I'm going to show you about primary keys and foreign keys. So, you know, do subscribe our channel. That will really help me to make more such videos. So thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.